This video is sponsored by, are you unemployed? Now not to worry. Jobs for All People is here. Just visit the website, and search for your dreams job. Apply for the job. And boom. You're employed. Link is in the description. Go and check it out. Welcome back, today our video is about history of dinosaurs, on Earth. What would happen, if dinosaurs lived with humans? That will be discussed in another video. Do subscribe, and hit the bell icon. Let's begin. Dinosaurs first appeared between 247 and 240 million years ago. They ruled the Earth for about 175 million years, until an extinction event 65.5 million years ago wiped out all of them, except for the avian dinosaurs. Scientists don't agree entirely on what happened, but the extinction likely was a double or triple whammy involving an asteroid impact, choking chemicals from erupting volcanoes, climate change, and possibly other factors. Only the big, classic dinosaurs are extinct. Birds are living dinosaurs, most experts believe. Fossils show that some of the more advanced dinosaurs had feathers or feather-like body covering, but many of them didn't fly, and probably didn't even glide. Archaeopteryx, which was for a long time considered to be the first bird, could likely launch itself from the ground, but probably couldn't fly far. Feathers likely helped these bird-like dinosaurs stay warm as juveniles, or send signals to other individuals. Many people think extinct flying reptiles called pterosaurs were dinosaurs. They were dinosaurs' closest relatives, but technically, not dinosaurs. Pterosaurs had hollow bones, relatively large brains and eyes, and, of course, the flaps of skin extending along their arms, which were attached to the digits on their front hands. The family includes pterodactyls, with elaborate, bony head crests, and lack of teeth. Pterosaurs survived up until the mass die-off, 65 million years ago, when they were winged, the way of the dodo, along with marine reptiles, and other non-avian dinosaurs. Dinosaur fossils were first recognized in the 19th century. In 1842, paleontologist Richard Owen coined the term dinosaur, derived from the Greek dinos, meaning terrible, or fearfully great, and saurus, meaning lizard or reptile. Scientists classify dinosaurs into two orders, saurischians and ornithischians, based on the structure of the bones in their hips. Most of the well-known dinosaurs, including T-Rex, Deinonychus, and Velociraptor, fall into the order known as saurischian dinosaurs. These reptile-hipped dinosaurs have a pelvis that points forward, similar to more primitive animals. They are often long-necked, have large and sharp teeth, long second fingers, and a first finger that points strongly away from the rest of the fingers. Theropods walked on two legs, and were carnivorous. Theropod means beast-footed, and they are some of the fearsome and most recognizable dinosaurs, including Allosaurus and T-Rex. Scientists have wondered whether large theropods, such as Gigantosaurus and Spinosaurus, actively hunted their prey, or simply scavenged carcasses. The evidence points to the animals working together as opportunistic hunters. They would bring down prey, but also eat animals that were lying around. When fossil hunters found bones with bite marks on them, they wondered if theropods engaged in cannibalism. It appears now that the animals may have scavenged their own kind, but they didn't hunt down their own. Sauropods were herbivores with long heads, long necks and long tails. They were among the largest land animals ever, but they likely had small brains. The gentle giants like leaf-eating Apatosaurus, Brachiosaurus, and Diplodocus are part of this family. Ornithischian dinosaurs, a group that includes horned and frilled Triceratops, spiked Stegosaurus, and armored Ankylosaurus, are more mild-mannered plant eaters. These dinosaurs were beaked herbivores smaller than the sauropods. The Ornithischia often lived in herds and were prey to the larger species of dinosaurs. Interestingly, the Ornithischia shifted from a two-legged to a four-legged posture at least three times in their evolutionary history. and scientists think they could adopt both postures early in their evolutionary history. The finding came about after researchers realized that theropods and ornithischia had many anatomical features in common. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.